In my gearporn video, I told you guys we will do something really interesting with that, but unfortunately one of our friend, actually is a friend of Oron, the drone killer.
Second flight?
Oh, unfortunately it just dropped the application.
Fuck!
Yeah, let's start again.
Calibration,
go, start. Yala.
Connect.
No, oi, oi. Fell down, stop. Unfortunately, stop.
Again, the app?
Yeah. I just want to calibrate.
Maybe you start application.
Just start the calibration. Stop. Should I just fly without the calibration?
No. But you connected?
Yeah.
By Wi-Fi?
Yeah, I see. It's 100%. I can see the...
Yeah, and this is red.
Yeah, I hear it. I've seen
it. You can see the picture.
I hear it. I can move the camera.
What?
What the fuck?
What happened?
What you did? Uh-oh.
Let's try.
I think it has some same issue. I absolutely don't like how the sounds. It's like...
Now it's turning by itself.
Weird.
Limit. Look. That's the problem.
No. Oh God. Really, I cannot control this.
I think it's fly away now, huh?
Yeah, you're doing what you want. So I think... No!
Uh-oh! We can repair it again.
No signal.
Yeah, hold on. I think this drone is... There's some issue, no? Maybe the previous owner is sold because of this.
Oh my God. You think we broke it?
I think it's broken, yeah.
I hope not.
Fuck, guys. Shit. I think you have to switch off. And one propeller, yeah, this is definitely dead. Nice. So what's the name of this drone?
Parrot Bebop 2.
2?
Amazing drone.
High quality drone.
Just don't buy it.
I don't know. If I recorded the full crash, but I'm not sure. Because it's happened so fast.
But now I have 100% battery.
And this broke too.
The camera.
Yeah. I think this will be a nice webcam. it still can fly? What do you think? You know, the kids can buy these things on the second-hand market for €1 to run with it, like... Look.
Where is my 25 minutes? It was only 2 minutes. Fucking drone.
So, his friend is interested on this Cantorum 44. What is this? What's the German name of this? Orgel? What?
Orgel.
Orgel. Basically, this we find in some really weird, old, dusty, dirty basement in Berlin here on a Frankfurthalle. So then we picked up, and I didn't touch for almost 2 years or something like this. And actually, on the last month, I want to drop it to the garbage. We will take this and we will do some really precision cleaning inside. And also outside, we will try to fix this wood part on the side. I hope we can hear some noise from it, yeah?
Yeah, and the drum machine.
Okay, by the way, who are you?
I am Paul.
Paul?
Yes, I'm a visitor today.
So he's a visitor. He came from the YouTube to my BMS Studio YouTube channel. And actually, I think he will stuck here into the BMS studio for a long time, because he has a lot of interesting projects which is running under his hand. Let's pick up this precision tool for renovating a lock. This will be fine enough, no? Yes. I will repair with this really precision German tool. Just for let's make this really shiny, miny. I think it's really shiny now. Start to get back the original shape and color. Good, maybe here, just a bit on a corner, and here also. You see? Now it's really. Really nice and really shiny. Let's work a bit on a leg. And good. Yeah, I think it's absolutely original, gorgeous condition. Ah, here also. I think, yeah, this is good. Very nice. Wait. Okay, so we have some problem with some keys, as you see. So the springs are missing, they are broken, and somebody tried to fix it with some animal method, just like how I did the side. And yeah, a lot of keys are damaged. So let's do some cleaning. Sorry guys for the noise, but this is the only way how we can clean out. There is no other method. Ah! This is some kind of German online speaker, but it looks to me like some monochore. It can be. It looks like a monochore. This is the foot pedal with yeah, I think it's not a foot pedal anymore, but inside some kind of weird, I don't know, I think it's not a pot meter. I think it's some kind of optical sheet, because on that side I see some optical receiver and here is a lamp. So I think this is the power source for all these shitty electronics and all the oscillators. By the way, this is really interesting. Every note have its own oscillator. So C sharp, D, D sharp, E, F, F sharp, G, G sharp, A sharp, B, and C. So this is, I think, the oscillator for the top keyboards. But I now have clue how the bass pedal and how the bass is generated. So definitely we will see here some kind of really interesting connection and electronics. So let me clean now this also, this part. Oh! Ah! I think this is the reverb tank. We will open this and I will show you guys how this German reverb tank, yes, I'm 100% sure because it's mounted on some kind of spongy, springy kind of material, and even here you can see there is some kind of gummy, some rubber feet, and I see here one hole, and I see here other hole, and I see already there is some kind of spring is mounted on it. So this arrived back to my lab, and first what we have to do is to take off this power unit and check all the fuses. Maybe we have here some kind of problem, and of course to give some chooch into it. So I think this is the first step what we have to do. By the way, I see here two quarter inch connector. This is can be line input or line output. What do you think? It's a
switch maybe.
Maybe no, this is the switch. I don't know, we will check what is this. And let's apply some pixies to here. So here in Germany, if you want to find a TV and hi-fi and whatever, you can find a lot on the street, and the people actually they're cutting the cable down. It's like a signature of something really wrong with the unit. So I hope we can find this issue. But back to this power source plus amplifier together, and really I now have clue what it's doing. So it's really interesting, this three diode. I'm really confused about that. And I also confused about this is the main. So the old main is coming into the fuse, and from the fuse is going across this capacitor to somewhere up to the other electronics. Maybe the oscillators are synced to the 50 hertz of the main. I now have clue. So let's first clean this from here, or nice. Good. So now we came with the VD40, just a little bit to remove the rust from inside. Yeah, now we get some. Steel is running on steel, so now this is definitely clean inside. And now we came with the Vaseline spray to inside to the potty, and we're done with this potty. Yeah, like new. Okay, this is the original position. So on the other potty, I just will do a really, really short cleaning because of the oxidation. And I'm telling you guys, the best corrosion remover material in a whole planet on pot meters is the VD40. So now let's move this potty to some other position, and now we can reach the original spot. And I don't know actually what this pot is doing. Mainly I think it's some kind of preamp. So it's already maxed out in the past by somebody. And now we connect the main cable back to here. German Olger repaired with German tools. Knipex, Germany. I hope we will get some noise immediately after we fix the main electricity cable. Okay. So, where? To the yellow. Huh? It was here, no?
I don't know.
Fuck! Good. And this one to here. So now the power source is done with this amp and preamp. Let's put it back and I hope we will hear some noise from this puppy. This is really nice. I'm telling you guys, this is optical pedal system. When you press down the pedal, this plastic or metal, yeah, this is metal, part is came to the way of the light. So when you press down on other side, you have this photoresistor block. I can take out, yeah. So this is the photoresistor inside. So how you press the pedal, it have some kind of logarithmic shape here. It's cutted into the metal. So when you press down, of course it's closing the way of the light, which is reaching this photoresistor. Really nice, no? It's not a pot meter. And why they did that, I'm 100% sure, because they know already it will collect a lot of dust. Maybe you saw on a redneck cleaning section of this video, it have here a lot of dust. So they know that, and they don't want to place here a pot meter, because it really can fuck up easily. It's much more, it's really nice construction. And there is a lot of adjustment here. Actually, here we have adjustment with screws and I don't know, some spring behind. It's everything about how you can adjust this optical pedal. So I really like this construction, and now I learned something, and maybe one of my future development, I will use this technique to make pedal controlling. I hope the lamp is working. So one drawback of this solution, if your lamp is going out, then of course the whole pedal is not working, and I hope this bulb inside, this light bulb, it's working. So this is the moment of the truth. I don't think so. Oh, no. Oh, I find the power switch. Okay, now finally I get familiar with that. But actually it sounds good.
Yes.
I like it. Only the problem is, of course, these keys, these ones, are pressing the switch. So then, those notes start to play. And maybe we have a same issue somewhere here. This one. Okay. So a couple of springs of course are missing, and because of that a lot of keys are ignited. But let me tell you, I'm really like the sound of this. It sounds fantastic. Really nice. Yeah, the quality of this keys, I'm telling you guys, is like a piece of garbage. The guy who will get it now soon, in a couple of hours, he will come for it. He will be really happy with that because, yeah, we get some sound from it, and yeah, there is a lot of keys are fucked up, and then it needs to be really, really to take to the parts, and he must need to be cleaned out everything inside. Okay, so still, we now have clue. Cancel. I heard something. You hear it? Tick, tick, tick.
Yes.
Okay. So now we switch to the internal microphone of the camera, and maybe on that way you guys can hear a lot of stuff. So this is the level for the reading machine, and this is the tempo. So let's push up the level. Bit speed up. Yeah!
Now try to rock.
Go, sit to rock. Yeah. This is really analog. Absolutely analog, eh? Foxtrot. Okay, waltzer. This is waltzer. Western. I like the Western. You, nice. You hear it? Yeah, really nice. I like it. Good. Polka. So switch to polka. Eh, boring, eh? Rumba. Oh. Oh, really nice. This. Yeah, I really like it. Okay, let's go to Bossa Nova. Wow. Yeah, still. You hear that?
Sounds like
the reverb is working, yeah. So yeah, we managed to get some sound from it. And actually, really like it, as is. Yeah, this drum machine is not the clearest sounding drum machine on the planet. But hey, this is for free. We find it in the garbage. And yeah, I actually like the bass also, like. We really like this piece of garbage because it's can generate a really nice sounds, and yeah, I like the rhythm machine, how it's producing the sound, and yeah, it's not the cleanest sound on the planet, but definitely there is a lot of interesting stuff inside. So, by the way, here now you can see how this Cantorum 44 is generating the tone. So each each tone has its own oscillator. So here you can see C, B, da, 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 da. So each one has its own oscillator. Then from these oscillators, of course, to with controlled by the keyboard, it's running into this, let's call it effect board, yeah? So this effect board, what it's doing is only mixing the original oscillator sound with some kind of subharmonics and other harmonics with really nasty passive modifications. So when you switch a switch here, of course, the oscillators are running on different configuration. There is only two transistors, and it's really pretty simple stuff here. And we cannot manage get to work the reverb because I think because of this switch. But yeah, we had a lot of fun with that. I hope the new owner, this guy, will be really happy with that because he has to work on that a lot.
You think it will fit? No way. No way. So he is the new owner of the Cantorum 44. What's your name?
Carlo.
Carlo.
Carlos. It's a box of
your wife?
Yeah, my wife.
What
Sliced
is this?
Them to pieces.
What is this?
CDs.
CDs?
Music.
Wow, very nice. Really nice. Fuck! Oh! The car is smaller than the inside.
80 could work.
No, it's 86.
86?
Yeah.
So we have to cut the sides.
Yeah, we have to cut.
Yeah.
So what you wanna do? To cut down the sides?
Yeah.
Of this really expensive Cantorum 44? No, I think you have to
We cut this sides.
We cut the car.
We cut the car.
Yeah.
We make the car fit.
Okay, I think it will not fit. So, what you say about your Citroën is too small for?
It's very good, but I can just get corpses inside. That dead bodies is good for dead bodies, but not this bad dead body.
So on the end, what's happened here is his car is small Citroën cannot handle this 86 centimeters. So then I give to him my car to carry this Cantorum 44. Yeah, he said he will do some really nice job. He want to paint it to gold, and his wife will put some stickers on it, like
some unicorns,
stickers. Unicorns and whatever. So yeah, bye bye, Cantorum 44. Okay guys, I hope you guys enjoyed, so catch you next time.